my brothers, tell me off.
Are you finished?
So, to finish my point, if I were to tell my experience, or he tells you his experience, how God saved him, how God brought him into his religion, it doesn't give or make his religion or my religion true because of my experience. Would you agree?
Yes, exactly.
Thank you. Now carry on.
Are you finished?
Now carry on. I'm finished. I'm finished.
Let me now ask.
Carry on.
Okay. I'm not able to answer all of your questions because some of the stuff is still a mystery to me. But I would like to ask you a question. Can I now ask you a question?
Sure.
Do you believe in the person of Jesus described in Quran?
Of course, I'm a Muslim, I have to believe in it.
Did he exist as described by Quran?
Absolutely.
What does make you convinced that Jesus Christ, described by Quran, 400 or 500 years later after he died, what does it make you believe that this image described in Quran is more truthful than the image described in the Bible by 12 disciples, by other witnesses? It's not logical to believe the testimony of one person. You know, I can come and say, you know, I can claim I have a revelation and describe something by myself. But if 12 witnesses said something different before, obviously I'm wrong. And this is my question. Why do you believe in the picture of Jesus Christ described in Quran if there are many more witnesses who describe Jesus Christ in the Bible? You don't believe that picture?
Okay, I'll tell you. Quick answer is, it comes from revelation. So because I believe the Quran is a revelation from God and I am convinced of it because of the evidence it provides, so I know whatever the Quran says about Jesus, about Moses, even about Noah and Abraham and Adam, thousands of years before the New Testament, I accept that as a true account. Yeah, this is my short answer. My long answer, not too long, but just for the sake of this discussion, is this.
Yes.
If we want to know about what happened during the flood, when God flooded the world because of what men did, we need to go the closest at the time. The earliest account you have is about 1400 years. I mean, how much? 2000. One second. I'm answering.
But the answer is,
I am answering.
Here at this
can
point.
Can I answer? I'm answering. The New Testament or the Old Testament is not 3000 years old. It's not 2000 years old. But it describes events which are older than this. And yet you believe them to be true accounts. You believe when God says how he created the heavens and the earth, thousands and millions perhaps years before, you believe, even though the Old Testament and New Testament is only 2000 years old, you believe this is a true account. The reason why you believe so, because you believe the Bible, the account is from God. So it doesn't matter if the Bible describes events thousands of years before, because of the fact that you believe Bible is from God, for your reasons of your belief, that's why you accept it. Likewise, I believe the Quran is from God, and I have my reasons to believe. I can share with you if you're interested. And since God tells us what happened with Christ, what happened with Moses, what happened with Abraham, what happened with Adam, I say this is the accurate, clear picture, story or history from God himself. That's why I accept it. It doesn't have to be say, oh, it's 500 years later, that means it is a weaker account.
It is a witness by one man who was Muhammad, right?
No, it's not this point. The point is, once we understand and confirm that the Quran is from God,
yes,
then it's irrelevant if 12 disciples or 100 disciples said it, because the Quran will say what they have interacted. Can I finish my point? Then please continue. If 100 disciples wrote it and the Quran is confirmed it's from God and it went against what they said, it doesn't matter if 100 disciples wrote it. We would say their writing is distorted of historical accounts. And I have reasons to believe that the account that you have in your Bible is distorted.
Okay, sir. So, the same way I will answer you your first question. Mm. Because we experienced and we believe Bible is true, divine, inspired by Holy Spirit, I'm not fully understand the person of Jesus Christ because it's so infinite, you know, it's so he's Son of God, I believe that because the Bible says so. On that basis, I can answer your first question. I believe because the Bible says so. As you said, you believe in the picture of Christ, even though tens of disciples describe him differently. You didn't give me an answer.
What did I say last thing? That I have reasons to believe.
Let me finish. Please. Yeah. So, this is not an answer that you believe. You didn't give me a reasonable answer. You gave me, you believe Quran is holy and divine, and you just take it. I believe Bible is divine and holy, and I can just say, I take it. Okay. Sir, I need to go. Thank you very much for
that. That's fine. Just to wrap this discussion up, you need to be consistent in the logic or approach that you use. Do you believe? I have been totally consistent. If I'm inconsistent, if you feel I'm inconsistent, show me the inconsistency. Okay. I'm willing to be corrected. Yeah.
Do you believe that Jesus is the truth? And Jesus, when he says that it is fulfilled,
thank you, sir.
When he accomplished everything, that was the day when he accomplished what he had to do here on earth. But before that, he says that after me, many false prophets and teachers gonna come and you deceive many.
And there were true ones as well, right? And true ones as well?
He says many false prophets.
Did he say? Did he also say there will be true ones? Did he say true ones as well? Did he talk about true, the spirit of truth? Did he say true? How you know they're true? Yeah. Let me.
If Jesus was a prophet.
He was a prophet, of course.
Yeah.
He was a worshipper of God.
Sir, my English is not good. Yeah?
He can help you.
Have you been reading the book of the prophet Jesus?
The book of prophet Jesus is no longer with anyone. Shall I tell you why? If we now examine what is written about him, there were not only four gospels that were written. We have evidence now of 43 gospels. Have you read all of these 43, the remaining? You haven't. Have you? Wait. Please. One second. You believe in four gospels, right? Matthew, Mark, Luke, John? But there are many gospels written. Why don't you believe in them?
I tell you why.
I believe in the entire Bible.
Because the first was age, yeah? And was the first age. Before the first was Mark, it was 68 near age, yeah, exactly.
Czy po kościołach chodziły wypowiedzi Jezusa, zanim was to wolne wypowiedzi. To się wiele zachowało. Wolnych wypowiedzi, przypowieści Jezusa, zanim była spisywana Ewangelia. Powiedz
mi. I need to, you know what it is.
Okay, let me continue with you, because he's had some difficulties. So, I want to leave you with some thoughts, because you're going. Leave you with some thoughts, right, to think and reflect. This is a... Listen.
No,
sorry.
Sorry, I've spoken with you.
No. The reason why we are not having a very good, meaningful discussion because of your language barrier. So I'm going to leave with him some thoughts to think about it. You believe Jesus is God, and you believe the Father is God, right? And you believe they are all powerful. So I'm going to ask you to think about it.
Can I ask first, right?
And then you can ask. This tripod, right? Imagine Jesus wants to take this tripod from here to here. Is he able to do that? He is, right? He's powerful. Imagine the Father says, I'll keep it here. What's going to happen to the tripod? One second. Wait. So Jesus is not independent. He is dependent on the Father.
When he came on earth, he was only doing the Father's will.
Before he came on the earth. Before he came.
I'm going to return to my Father where I'm going to sit on the right hand side.
So now, if Jesus wants to move this tripod from here to here, he's able to do that. But if the Father says, no, I want to keep it here, what's going to happen?
Jesus was only doing what the Father was telling him.
No, remember. You said he's God. God doesn't have to listen to anyone. He is all powerful, sovereign. His will doesn't need to be subjugated to someone else. That's what I mean by independent. if Jesus is independent, then he should be able to do that. And the Father is independent, he should be able to keep this tripod here. What's going to happen?
But this is your will now.
No.
Can I ask you something about the Quran?
Please listen. It's important. No, you can ask. I have no problem. But let's deal with this. Is the Father not able to will this tripod to be here? He can. He can will it. It's only a tripod to remain here. It's not a difficult thing for God to do. If the Father wills it to remain here, and at the same time the Son wants to bring it here, what's going to happen?
But the Son is not doing his own will.
So the Son is not God.
His will.
The Son is not God.
Why
thank you. Thank you very much.
Christ is the visible image.
No.
Of the
thank you
God.
For affirming.
That's First Colossians. No.
Thank
that
you,
Christ
my friend.
Is the visible image of the
before you ask, God. Before you ask your question.
Look.
Whatever, if God, imagine, God listens to another. To another God is not God.
Jesus says, "Me and my Father are one."
Listen.
What does it mean?
So any being,
so
he says, "I can't do anything unless you give me the permission." Then that's not God.
Look, in the Quran, you says that you have to obey all the prophets. Yes.
No.
You have to trust all the.
We believe in them and the messages it was sent to them. So the messages that have been sent with them, no one has them in preserved.
But that's the Quran says that you have to obey all the prophets.
The Quran tells us as Muslims to believe in the revelation, what was sent to them. We believe in the original revelation that was sent to them. But the original revelation has undergone corruption, as we have seen in Christianity. 43 Gospels, who wrote them? They call themselves Christians. And you know, they lied against God by writing them.
Who did write the Quran? Did Muhammad write the Quran?
No. Quran is from God. He's only dictating to people to write it. He has no involvement in terms of production of the Quran because the speech that contained within the Quran is the speech of God, not the speech of Muhammad. That is why we have absolute confidence that what is in the Quran is the words of God, not words of men.
And what makes you believe that the Quran is from God and not from the angel?
I'll tell you. I told earlier, the Quran has evidence for it. For example, Quran says if you think it's not from God, then produce a chapter like unto it. The fact that people fail to produce a chapter like unto the Quran, to falsify it, it is exactly as it's claiming it's from God. Because if it wasn't from God, you were able to imitate it, match it. The fact that you can't demonstrates that it's from God.
But the Quran been given to Muhammad first. Do you believe that Muhammad is a man of God?
Yeah, of course.
But Muhammad married an 8-year-old girl and he slept with her.
So let's understand that. So
how can that let's understand that.
So you're saying God produced a child from a woman only called Mary, and with no father. And you see no problem with that. You say it's okay.
Because the Holy Spirit
came
to conceive.
Let's
Mary.
Understand that. A Christian questioning about the morality of someone marrying a young. Isaac in your Bible married Rebecca when she was 3 years old. 3 years old. Condemn your Bible. You don't know that because no one like speakers only in speakers' corner you come across this and you're shocked. Is it true? So when you go and study, read about Isaac and Rebecca and their marriages. At what point Isaac married Rebecca? Because you don't know.
How old was she when you said?
3 years old.
When she was 3 years old, she couldn't talk the way she talked in the Bible. Because when
she didn't need to talk.
One second.
It's an arranged marriage.
Let me finish. He was talking in the Bible. In this description, when she was talking with her parents. The way she talked there, it's not possible for a child of 3 years old. So please stop saying lies about the Bible. Like,
that really shows you have not...
Let me finish.
But don't say I'm lying, because you have not studied the subject, have you? Have you studied the subject?
I have studied the subject, and she was not 3 years old.
Okay, how old was she?
She could be like 10, 11 years old.
Stop. Wait, stop.
Or even more.
Sorry, don't say even more. 10-year-old, is that a child or a woman?
In those times...
What do you think? A 10-year-old is a child or a woman?
Wait.
Maybe your help is needed from your friend.
In the medieval times, in the old times...
Carry on.
Women were considered like 12, 13 years old.
Oh, so now, brother, your friend needs to tell you about marriage in the old times, how people reached adulthood early. So your friend is confirming what I was going to tell you. In the olden times, people would mature early. Today we have the period of adolescence and so on and so forth. Thank you. You need to have a conversation between yourself.
That is actually true.
Right. Is there any other objection do you have about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because that is totally dismissed.
Hey guys, we need to go. Thank you very much for the discussion.
You take care. It's been nice talking to you.
But sir, Rebecca was not 3 years old because...
We haven't discussed on it. It's your statement against my statement. If you have time, we can go and sit down and talk.
All right.
But another
take
time.
Care,
see you later.
This is what they believe. They never...
That's okay.
When Jesus appeared after the resurrection, do you know what the disciples said to him? My Lord and my God.
He talks, man, mashallah. Listen to you, okay?
Sir, I have no time.
I'm a Norwegian Muslim convert and I have a question about Islam. Can you help me answer it? If I made some food and gave it to my neighbors, would I be rewarded for that? I hear you saying yes. But what if I gave the gift of Islam to someone, like someone gave to me? Don't you think that would give me more reward than the food? Of course! Brothers and sisters, we have purchased a property to establish a masjid in the capital of Norway. By supporting our masjid, you will inshallah gain the reward for gifting Islam to our community. Imagine the children memorizing the Quran, the lines filling up for the prayers 5 times a day, the non-Muslims discovering the beauty of our deen. Subhanallah, all of that reward can be yours for a small donation. Allah said, believe in Allah and His Messenger and donate from what He has entrusted you with. So those of you who believe and donate will have a mighty reward. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever builds a masjid for Allah, Allah will build for him a similar house in Jannah. Click the link to help and gain the mighty reward promised by Allah. Also, please help us reach more people by sharing the video. May Allah grant you a palace in the highest level of Jannah. Ameen.